nothing quite so nice as that time of year when the leaves start turning red and gold. And there's a little nip in the air that tells you Old Man Winter's coming. That's when our story starts, right here in this little community. Not the community of houses where people live, but that other community close by in the trees, a place called Birdville. Now, it so happens that in Birdville, there's one citizen who's very special. And he sure looks special with his bright orange head and little green wings. But I suppose the thing that's most special about him is the way he talks, or rather, he doesn't talk. He can't make a sound. Instead of twittering or singing like other birds, when he wants to say something, bright orange pictures appear over his head. Right now, he's pretty sad because there's hardly a soul around, and it can get pretty lonesome without any friends.
Leaves are turning color, say goodbye to summer, haven't got the time to lay around the nest. Crowds are getting bigger, hustle up your bigger, pack your bag and gather with the rest.
Yeah!
Autumn winds are blowing, summer sun is snowing, everybody's heading for the sun.
Of a
feather. Time to get together. Join the flock of flying.
Come on.
Hey, what was that?
That was a sour note.
I didn't hear it.
I didn't hear it either, but I saw it.
Hey, man, you're messing up our song with that orange fog. What kind of bird are you, anyway?
Did you ever see a bird that couldn't sing?
I never did till now.
Oh, gee, fellas. We made the orange bird blue.
Hey, what are you doing around here, anyway? Winter's coming. It's time to head south. Oh, no. You're not going with us. Nothing personal, pal. It's just that flying south is a long, hard trip. You couldn't keep up. But here's a little advice. Before you try flying south, you'd better get in shape. Go see Doc Owl. He'll tell you what to do. So long.
So, you want to fly south to find new friends, eh? Ooh, that's a long, hard trip. We'd better see what kind of shape you're in.
Oh, if I could only find my glasses. That's right. Hey, stand up there and let me take a good look at you. You could certainly use a little more meat on your bones. Yeah, here, stick this thermometer in your mouth while I check your pulse.
Oh,
very weak. Now, let's check your heart. Got to see how the old ticker's doing, you know. My heavens, how irregular. Now for the blood pressure. We'll just wrap this cup around your arm. Oh, no muscle tone at all. I don't believe it, my friend. You're falling apart. You ought to see a doctor. Oh, yes, I am a doctor, aren't I? Now, pay close attention. First, I want you to get plenty of rest and exercise. What? Well, my goodness, my glasses. Wherever did you find them? Now, where was I? Oh, yes, over here I have a chart which will illustrate the essential elements of a good diet. Oops, sorry. That's the window shade. Oh, here we are now. Good nutrition is an essential part of good health, and to eat properly, you must select a balanced diet from a variety of foods. Now, from the grain, as you can see, come foods that give us energy. Like cereals and buns and breads, spaghetti, too, would work instead. The protein foods that you must eat are poultry, fish, and eggs and meat. The basic thing that you should know is proteins help the body grow. Calcium is what you need to strengthen teeth and bones, indeed. It comes from things like milk and cheese, dairy products, if you please. Now, vitamins and minerals are found in item 4. You see, they're fruits and vegetables. But wait, there's even more. Now, pay attention.
Fiber makes a meal complete. We need it in the food we eat. So let me make it very clear. You'll get lots of fiber here. Variety is what you'll find in the food I have in mind. A balanced diet will supply nutritious meals to help you thrive.
Oh, thank you very much. Now, I recommend that you get right to work. It's going to take time to build yourself up. You've got to get busy if you hope to be on your way south before winter comes.
Oh, I hope he makes it. I've never seen anybody in such terrible shape.
Well, sir, the little orange bird started in right away on his self-improvement program. After a good night's sleep, the next thing was to have a good, nutritious breakfast to start the day.
He decided to have some whole grain cereal with milk on it. For protein, he chose a fresh egg. And to complete his breakfast, a glass of orange juice.
Next on his list was exercise.
Dude, what in Sam Hill is going on out here? You better stop them silly shenanigans before a whole shooting match lets go in. Now you done it, Sonny. I'll have to scoop up my whole supply of nuts.
Well, it had taken time and a lot of hard work. But finally, the little orange bird was in good shape for the long flight south. And none too soon, because winter winds were already howling through the bare branches of Birdville. The little orange bird kept flying on and on, and the weather kept getting warmer. When he spotted the swampy land of the Everglades dead ahead, he knew he was heading into the deep south. He was also heading into deep trouble.
Gator won't bother anybody for a while. Hey there, pal. You put on quite a show. I've been watching you. How'd you get here, anyway? You flew all the way? Built yourself up, huh? Got lots of rest? Ate the right kind of food? Got plenty of exercise? Well, I'll be. You sure worked hard to get down here to find a friend. Hey, wait a minute, pal. Not me. I've got a long way to go yet. If you really want to find friends, you just head that way over to the beach. See you later.
There. It's finished.
But we need some flowers for the garden. Oh, thank you. They're just right.
Hey, look. He wants to play with us.
Oh, isn't he cute?
The king and queen of this castle dubbed the Sir... Sir...
Orange Bird. Sir Orange Bird.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, that's a great castle. It even has its own flower garden.
And it has its own special knight.
Oh, a little orange bird. He came to play with us.
He wants to be our friend. Can he stay with us?
Oh, come on now, kids. We've already got too many pets at home.
But, Dad, he must be something special.
Oh, can't he come home with us?
Can he come home with us, please, Dad?
I'm sorry, kids, but we don't need another pet. On your way now. Shoo. Well, I'm going down to the pier to see if I can catch a couple of fish.
Be careful, dear.
No, I'll be careful. What the? Shoo, get away. What's the matter with you? little fella. Now I understand. You were trying to warn me that the pier was unsafe, weren't you? The kids were right. You really are a friend. Well, there's always room for one more friend. Hop on.
I wonder how long your father will be. I'm hungry.
Here he comes.
And he's got the little orange bird with him.
What happened, dear?
I'll tell you later. But right now, let's eat. My little friend and I are starved.
Hooray! Hey, what's he doing?
He wants to help serve.
Didn't I tell you all along he was smart?
The family has gathered round, and we have got a friend we found to join us here and settle down to have a family picnic. Our basket's filled with fruits and meat and other things we like to eat. A real nutritious luncheon treat to have a family picnic. We're serving lots of sandwiches we made from whole grain bread. They meet our needs for cereals, and in between the bread, we pack them full of protein, like meat and eggs, you see. We'll take the cup and fill it up with juice for vitamin C. For teeth and bones, we ask you please, for dairy foods like milk and cheese. They help complete this special treat, a happy family picnic. The basic foods, we all agree, provide the right variety. A balanced meal for you and me at our family picnic.
And this is how our story ends. Orange Bird has found his friends.